So what you'll see in today's video is me sharing the work session where I create this entire overhead set of cabinets. Now, here at the beginning, I want to share with you the cluster, which is the simplified script, so you can see how the changes can be made and also how you can set your own curve to change the location of this. So if you want to download this, you can go to my website. I'll have this available for this month, along with other scripts that I also released. And the reason why I say that is because if you download that file, you'll find two scripts. The one where I made it at the beginning. So that's going to be this design. And then you'll also find the cluster, which is this, the simplified version. Now let's go over how this is changed and how you can use this. First thing is we have a parametric line segment that we create down here. Now the reason why the line segment is down here and the cabinets are up here is because these are overhead cabinets, which typically are offset from the base cabinets. Now, that's what I did here is allow you to change the location of the cabinets. You can also change the height. So let's say if you want them to be like 24 inch height, the depth, we can also change that. So these are 24 inch deep. Typically overhead cabinets are a little bit more shallow. Here we have all of the materials that create this. Now to show you how it's constructed, what I'll do is I'll take these outputs, the ones that are not hidden, and I'll go here to middle click and bake and bring this over to the side. So you can see how this is constructed. Now, what I'll do is I'll go here to a new layer, layer one. I'll bring in a clipping plane. I'll go to vertical. So this way we create a vertical section. And I'll go through the middle here. So you can see the construction. Here we have the sides. The bottom part actually goes halfway in. The shelf is flush with all of these materials, although we could create a tolerance. Here you see that how the sides are actually offset from the side and also go into that. So it's a bit of a insert that is created for construction. And now let's rotate this around the other way. So you can see the construction this way. So here we have the outside frame. Here we have the base, the back, and the top. The other thing is when you hide this, you'll see that there's the face frame. And that's typically made so when you open and close, you have that face, and not just a thin lip. So I'll go here to show. I'll delete this. I just wanted to show you how that was made. All right, so now that you've seen, for the most part, how this is changed, obviously all of the things and the decisions that were made for creating this are going to be right here. Let's see if there's anything that I find that's critical to share here. I'll disable the preview on the doors here. Now, what I like to show is how, let's see here. Here we have the sides. Now we do need to override the sides that have the pins, because from what I see, these two, that's the top, these are the sides. So I'll go in here, it'll be the top one. And these need to be overridden with, let's see. Oh, it's because those were not moved up. Yeah, I see how that works. So the pins were not moved up. So this will move them up. and then this will subtract them. Make sure that it does that right. So I had a bit of a mistake here. Now we can disable preview and see if this is taken care of up here. Okay, so the pins are here. Now let's go here to pin spacing. From the center, number of pins, let's see here, 10, we'll just go to 5. Here's why. So I hadn't fixed that issue. So now that it's there, you'll see that we can change the location. So we'll see that where those pins are, I have set it so the shelf would sit right on top, and you can pick which one of the shelves it sits on. So for now, we'll go here, keep it here in the middle, and typically shelf depth, go to 0.5, we'll go here to 2. So notice that when you have a cluster like this, you don't necessarily even have this as a finalized script. You can go inside, and as long as you know how to work with the cluster inputs and outputs and know how you created your whole design, you can always go back in and adjust things that maybe you feel like were not fixed. And then here at the end, you can save it and everything will be working. All right, the next step is combining this with the base cabinet. So that's what I'm going to be doing in a second here, is showing you how this in combination with the base cabinets is really the what you can use in your projects to develop, let's say, a kitchen. All right, so I'll be opening up the last cluster that I made in the last set, and it was the base cabinet. So that's this one. What I'll do is I'm actually going to take this whole thing, copy it, and bring it over to the other script. Then I'll paste this here, Control V, paste. Now notice that this is asking for a curve. Well, we already have that parametrically in here. So let's take this line segment, whether it's this one or this one, I'll actually go like this, wire display hidden. So I can actually bring this down here and override this one. Now I'll disable the preview on all of this and preview these down here. Now let's see which ones are the critical ones. So all of these, this has two different sets. This has the full door, the full door, single door, to be this one. I'll disable the preview on that and this. Now I'll bring over some of these materials. I can use the same color. This will be for the handle. This will be for the door. This will also be for the door. So holding down shift, I can add that. And then let's see where the frame and sides are. This is frame. This is the side. Holding down shift, I'm adding more. Then the face frame, it's for this one. The drawer, we'll add it to here. And on the inside, we have the shelf. We'll add it here. The top door, we already did that. And the handle. Now here's the thing. The handle here, that's incorrect. It should be here in the middle. So what I like to do is, let's see where the issue is on this one. So I'll double click inside. I'll know that it has to be the line segment that created this. So I have to go in here and figure out by back engineering where the handle is. Now let's see here. Notice that this is it. So if that's it, then this is the extrusion, then this is what moved it, then this is the surface that used to move. These are the joined curves. And those joined curves are based off of a line segment. And this line segment was created, let's see here, back here, using these points. And using this line segment. So how did this line segment get created? Well, it was from this. And if we look at which line it selected, was this one. We need to pick either the top or this one. So now I'll change that. Notice that just by changing this to zero, that was the solution to it. So yes, it's confusing once you already made it into a cluster. It's not as intuitive, but all of your work is here. So if you've been very diligent and very careful as to how, what you've done with your script up to this point, you can always go back and fix issues like this. So I'll go to save and close. And now we have this. Let's see where the handle is. This one that could go into this material. But notice now that we've got base cabinets and overhead cabinets with the same length of this. So if this is 48, we'll make them 36. If you want them to be double door or single doors, those are the things that we can change here. Like these two, this is the door and this is the handle. And we can disable the preview on this and all of this. Actually, there's one last thing. This and this. Let's see. This one goes here. I also do draw only preview geometry, and that helps me visualize it. Now we have top one, the top drawer, the bottom drawer. You have the option of both double door, single door. We have the location of the overhead cabinets. And all of the details that can be changed here, just within these two scripts. So now you're seeing that if you're an architect or a designer and you do a lot of kitchens, a lot of 3D designs, you would benefit from being able to create scripts like this. Why? Because once you have a kitchen, and that's one of the things that I will get into a little bit later on, is floor plan design and how you can use these scripts within a floor plan. Let's say you have a 3D design and you have a kitchen layout. Well, you can go through and finish your entire kitchen layout just using these scripts, figuring out what is your cabinet height location. And typically, whatever cabinet height this is, you can have a countertop and then you have 18 or 20 inches between the top of the countertop to this. So let's go here to the outputs. Middle click and bake. They'll bake into whatever layer you have currently. So now we'll go to default, change object layer. Now you're seeing that the countertop would be something like this. We'll create a box from here to here. Do 1.5 inches. Overhang this by 1.5 minus 1.5. And then depending on whether you have an overhang here or not, this is the idea. That if we go to clipping plane, vertical, you have a very nice clean set of cabinets that you can use for your projects. So at the end of this video, what you'll see is the entire work session of me creating this whole script. Now you're only going to see the overhead cabinets. I just posted a video with the whole process on creating these base cabinets. The idea is very similar, but the obviously some of the steps that we took were a little bit different. The things that would make this even better is this. Right now we have a cluster that has a different number for this and a different number for this. Notice that the handles are a little bit bigger. So what's happening is the numbers here are not tied to some of these here, and they could be. The reason why is because the handles want to be consistent. The offset for the detail on the door wants to be consistent. So those are numbers that we can tie together within the script. That being said, if you want to learn how this was made, or if you want to see how the script was made from beginning to end, go to my website, download it. It'll be free for a month. So those of you who are into parametric design for architecture, you guys could learn a lot more and make some progress in that sense. Also, I would love to hear some feedback. If there are issues, if there are things that you're like, hey, I don't like this design for this case, for this scenario, maybe this would be a different approach. I love feedback like that. So thank you for being here. Hope you're excited, and I hope to see you on the next one. So I want to conclude this video by sharing with you the things that you can expect when you download this file. You're going to find this one, which is the combination of both the base and top cabinets. You'll also see the base cabinet as a separate script, and also the overhead cabinet as a separate script. So you can add those to your library and use some yourselves. You have this available for free for this month. I will be going on to other blocks for architectural designs. Just wanted to share that with you.